Refuge and my strength. Let us bow together in prayer. Let us pray. Lord, you are mighty yet gracious, magnificent yet gentle. We praise you, O Lord, as our creator and as our sustainer in life. Lord, our hearts are overflowing with gratitude for all that you are and all that you have done for us in our lives. And so in response to your goodness and your mercy, we join together to worship you, to meditate upon your word, and to delight in your holy presence. So come to us now, O Holy Spirit. Captivate our hearts and captivate our minds so that as we sing, as we pray, and as we meditate, it will all be holy and pleasing to your name. This we pray through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Reading from Psalm 4. Answer me when I pray, O God, my defender. When I was in trouble, you helped me. Be kind to me now and hear the prayer. How long will you people insult me? How long will you love what is worthless and go after what is false? Remember that the Lord has chosen the righteous for his own. And he hears me when I call to him. Tremble with fear and stop sinning. Think deeply about this. When you lie in silence on your beds, offer the right sacrifices to the Lord and put your trust in him. There are many who pray. Give us more blessings, O Lord. Look on us with kindness. But the joy that you have given me is more than they will ever have with all their grain and wine. When I lie down, I go to sleep in peace. You alone, O Lord, keep me perfectly safe. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen.
Let us bow together in prayer. Lord, your word illumines our hearts and transforms our lives. As we ponder upon your word for us today, we pray that you will open our ears to hear you, open our mind to understand you, and open our hearts to receive you. And now, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. The snippets of the psalm that we read today from Psalm chapter 4 show us different approaches that one may take to find a sense of peace in life. Firstly, the psalmist describes people who pursue peace by sinning. He gives two characteristics as examples. First, he says that they insult others. I recall one day meeting a fellow church member who was troubled by a particular national service that we had. He decided that the only way to fix the problem was to give the moderator at that time a good telling off. Friends, it happens. Sometimes when life gives us a little chaos or things don't go our way, we think that the only way that we can find peace is by exploding on those who may have wronged us. We may want to use some colorful language for those who bad drive us. We may lash out on our family and on our friends when they make mistakes. But friends, this is not a righteous path to peace. Instead, this is a path that continually relies on violence and hurts God's people. Another way we sin looking for peace is, as the psalmist says, they chase after worthless, false things in life. Sometimes, when we are grappling with difficulties in life, we turn to our empty vices. We try to find peace with our addictions to material things in life, to alcohol, to drugs, to lust, to money and parties and that fast life. But the psalmist reminds us that people who chase after these empty things in life will never be satisfied. They would always be asking God for more blessings. They will never feel that deep sense of spiritual peace. However, there is a source of peace that the psalmist describes as righteous and fulfilling. This is a type of peace that lets us sleep in peace. And let's be honest, for many of us, restful, peaceful sleep seems so far away when we are carrying the weight of life's burdens. Friends, this peace comes from calling upon the Lord. When we call upon the Lord, three things happen to us. Firstly, we remember who God is. As the psalmist cries out to God, he remembers who God has been in his life. He remembers that God is his defender. So think about your own life for a moment. What has God done for you in your own life? Who has God been for you? Has God been your healer, your guide, your protector? When we call upon our God, we remind ourselves who God has been to us personally, in our lives in an intimate way. And this gives us an immense sense of peace. Secondly, when we call upon the Lord, we remember who we are to God. The psalmist in his prayer remembers that in the eyes of God, he is righteous. And he says that because of this, the Lord listens to him. When we call upon God, we take that leap of faith and remember how precious and loved we are by God, that the Lord listens to all of us. So today, empty your needs before God. Pour out your prayers, your burdens and your worries, all those things that keep you from that restful sleep. Lay them before your God who loves you and who listens to you. Thirdly, when we call upon our God, we remember how mighty and faithful our God is in comparison to the pain that we are bearing. The psalmist remembers how God saved him from the trouble of the past. When we call upon our God in faith and remember that our God is mighty, magnificent, and wonderful, it is easier to put our trust in him. Remembering who God is when we call upon him reminds us that there is nothing that we can go through that God cannot save us from. No burden is too much. No trouble is too complicated. When we trust in God, we find peace. So in conclusion, friends, have you been finding peace lately? How have you been finding peace? Have you been hurting those around you? Have you been turning to empty and meaningless things in life? If so, it's never too late to find a deeper, truer sense of spiritual peace in our lives when we call upon the name of our Lord. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let this be good news for us all. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, you are indeed our rock and our salvation. We thank you, O Lord, that through any moment of life, we have this freedom to call upon you. We thank you, O Lord, for the grace that you have offered to us through your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for this freedom, and we thank you for this close relationship that we have through him. So, Lord, we pray that as we continue living as your disciples, that you will remind us to call upon you in every moment of life. When we call upon you, O Lord, we know we can be strengthened. And so, O Lord, we call upon your name in the midst of the suffering of this world. We call upon you for strength. We call upon you for healing. Lord, you see the hearts that are suffering with anxiety and depression. You see how your people are grieving. And we call upon your name, O Lord, because you alone can bring an everlasting peace to your people. Lord, we think about our brothers and sisters from St. Vincent. We remember the pain that they have had to endure, the trauma that they were called to experience. And we call upon your name, O Lord, and ask that you will bring freedom, you will bring healing where needed, that you will bring protection to your people and to those who are on the front lines working. As we think about those who are giving their lives to take care of your people, we pray for those who are working tirelessly through this pandemic. We pray for those who are putting their lives at risk every day. And we call upon your name, O Lord, to unravel healing upon this world. Grant us, O Lord, new insight through the research that is being done, so that together, O Lord, as we work, we will be able to be healed and celebrate a world without a pandemic. And so, Lord, we call upon your name as we remember our church. We thank you for this blessed body of Christ here on earth. We thank you for the work and the witness in ages past. But we pray, O Lord, that as we move toward your vision for us, that you will make us brave. Give us a heart of mission, O Lord, so that we will be able to lift our prophetic voice and dismantle every form of injustice here in our land. Hear us, O Lord, as we offer this prayer through the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Christ alone.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in heaven.
guilt in life.
No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my death.
May the love of God enfold us. May the peace of Christ sustain us. And may the fellowship of the Holy Spirit grant us unity within our community, now and forevermore. Amen.